So welcome to this new playlist on YouTube, which is all about linear algebra inside of Python, and more specifically, at least initially, using one of the libraries of Python called symbolic Python. So I'm going to show you how to install it, and then we're going to start using it. I am going to accept, though, the fact that you know a little bit of linear algebra, that you have studied it, that you are busy studying it, and that you can do most of what is required from an introductory course in linear algebra. So what I want to show you here is how to use Python and Sympy to perhaps check your homework, check that you understand what is going on in linear algebra, or just to test yourself in linear algebra, how to use a computer algebra system to solve the problems in linear algebra. That's what I want to show you. If you're interested in a proper course in linear algebra, I have two playlists. The first, which is on the card right there, is just a full course on linear algebra. I teach you how to do linear algebra, the concepts of linear algebra. The second one is almost similar. Cards up there, but I do concentrate on the use of the Wolfram language inside of Mathematica. So in this first lecture, we're just going to install Python. I'm going to show you where to go on the website and where to download it free of charge to install on your system. We are going to use what is called the notebook. It runs inside of your default browser, and it's a beautiful coding environment. So I've opened my web browser and I've typed in the address www.anaconda.com. Anaconda is a company. It has many clients, but one of the greatest things that it does for us as users is provide this package that will install Python and many, many libraries. We can download it free of charge and install. So here we are on the Anaconda website, and all I'm going to do is on the right-hand side here, click on download. And we get to this page, download Anaconda distribution. This one is as of October 25, 2017 with version 5.0.1. If I scroll down, I notice that there are installations here for Windows, macOS, and Linux. At the moment, it's on Windows, and if I scroll down, we see we have Python versions 3.6 and 2.7. Please ignore the 2.7. The end date for 2.7 is coming, and eventually it will no longer be supported. So let's stick with the newer versions, such as 3.6. You have here the option of Python for 64-bit and for 32-bit systems. The majority of us will use these 64-bit systems. So we can click on this, and it will download. Once it is downloaded, please click on it to start. For macOS, we see the same version 3.6 and 2.7. As I mentioned, stay with the 3.6. And for ease of use, stay with the graphical installer. Here we are with Linux. We see it's exactly the same thing. We have 64-bit and 32-bit. And we have for x86 and Power8. The vast majority of us are on x86 systems, so please install that. For any one of these versions, you might notice, let's go back to Windows, that there's a how to install Anaconda. Let's have a look. So here's the page for how to install on Windows, for macOS, and for Linux. Please read through those. What I want you to do during the installation process, though, is just accept all the defaults. Anaconda has made it really easy. Accept those defaults and do your installation. When you want to start the system in Linux, you would open a terminal window and type in Jupyter Notebook. That's J-U-P-Y-T-E-R space notebook. On macOS and on Windows, you can click on your menus where you will find your products, the applications that are installed on your system, and you can look for the notebook. Jupyter Notebook. Once you click on that, your default browser will open and you are ready to code.